Okay, we're going to cover how to solve systems of equations by graphing. So we're talking about solving systems of two linear equations by drawing both lines on the same graph and then finding their intersection. Three possibilities may occur. One, they could intersect at one point, and then the ordered pair that is at that point of intersection is the one and only solution. So here's an example. I've got line 1 and I've got line 2. And they cross at exactly one ordered pair, whatever that ordered pair is, that would be your solution. So you would like write down whatever that ordered pair is, there's some value for x and y, right? And then you'll have your solution to the system. The second possibility is that they're parallel. And when two lines are parallel, they don't intersect at all, so there is no solution. That's the answer to that one. There's going to be absolutely no solution. Those lines will never meet, so they'll never cross, they'll never intersect. And we say the system is inconsistent. In other words, you're giving us two lines and there is no solution. So we call that an inconsistent system. Okay, the third possibility is that you graph it and they're actually the same line. So in this case, all the ordered pairs on the line, you know, they're the same on both lines. So they intersect at every single point on the line. So this is called a dependent system because if you give me a value of x, then I could tell you what y goes along with it. For instance, if the equation was y equals x plus 1, example, y equals x plus 1, there are infinitely many solutions. You know, some solutions, well, like if x is 1, y would be 2, right? If x is 4, y would be 5, etc. It's impossible to list them all, correct? So it's not that they're just any old ordered pair, but if I am given a value of x, I could plug it in and figure out what y goes with it. So that's why we call that a dependent system. And we'll just write that there are infinitely many solutions. It's impossible to list all the solutions. You could say that all the solutions are on whatever the line is. Of course, it's the same line twice. All right, so now let's work through a problem. Okay, so find the solution to the system by graphing. So we have y equals negative 3x and 2x minus y equals negative 6. Okay, to make it easier, I'm going to change the color to this green. So we have a green equation and we have a blue equation. Now, you can use any graphing method you want to graph the line y equals negative 3x. There's several ways to do this. I'm going to do it using slope-intercept method, but you can do it by plotting some ordered pairs, other ordered pairs. All right, so put this on pause and graph the line y equals negative 3x and then see if you get the same thing I'm going to get. Okay, the graph of y equals negative 3x is shown. Notice the slope is negative and it's sort of steep as you'd expect and it's going through the point 0, 0, etc. Alright, now on the same set of axes you want to graph 2x minus y equals negative 6. Any method you want. I'm going to choose to do it using x and y intercepts, but you can solve for y and either make a list of ordered pairs or use slope intercept method. So go ahead and put it on pause. Figure out where your graph is. Make sure you have graph paper out and you're really careful drawing straighter lines than I'm drawing, and then check back. Okay, let's look at this system. Find the solution to the system by graphing. So we have two lines, equations, y equals negative 3x and 2x minus y equals negative 5. So there are two lines. The first line you need to graph, y equals negative 3x. So put it on pause and graph that on the axis shown here and then come back and see if you get the same thing I get. Alright, so I've graphed y equals negative 3x. I use the slope-intercept method starting at the y-intercept at 0, 0 and then thinking of the slope as negative 3 over 1, so over 1 and down 3, over 1 and down 3, etc. So I have a line, the slope is negative. In fact, it's negative 3. All right, now take the other equation, 2x minus y equals negative 5, and you want to graph this using any method you want. You can solve for y and use slope-intercept form, or you can solve for y and plot some ordered pairs, or you can use the x and y intercepts. So go ahead and put it on pause, try it, and then check back in. Okay, so the blue line is 2x minus y equals negative 5. If you had solved for y, it would be y equals 2x plus 5, so the slope was 2 over 1, and the y-intercept is 5, or you could have gotten the x and y-intercepts, which is negative 2 and a half, 0 for the x-intercept, 0, 5, etc. And you have to be very careful, and now we look and see that these have different slopes, so they're going to intersect at some point, and so we're just looking for the point of intersection, which you see right here, and that's the order pair negative 1, 3. So it looks like negative 1, 3 is the solution to this system. Of course, we have to check it, right? So let's check negative 1, 3 into y equals negative 3x first. So we're going to put in 3 for y, negative 1 for x, and yep, that's true because 3 is going to equal 3. And then let's check negative 1, 3 into 2x minus y equals negative 5. Always check it in the original, not the y equals 2x plus 5, because I might have made a mistake solving for y. So we have 2 times negative 1 minus 3 equals negative 5. That's 2, I'm sorry, negative 2 minus 3 is negative 5, and yes, negative 2 minus 3 is also negative 5. So the solution then is the ordered pair negative 1, 3, because that is a solution to both equations, and I solved it by graphing. I graphed both lines on the same set of axes, and then I looked for the point of intersection. Please watch my video on Systems Part 4 for more examples solving systems of equations by graphing, including two special cases.